Sarah Palin's latest trip to Iowa. At the premiere of a new documentary about her, the former Alaska governor said she's not running for anything just yet. CBS News political correspondent Jan Crawford is in Pella, Iowa, with more this morning for us. Jan, good morning.
Well, good morning, Chris. You know, last night, these streets were full of people, not only from just here in Pella, but from all over the state and the Midwest. I talked to some people who said they drove 5 and 6 hours to get here, and they didn't even have a ticket to the movie. It was sold out. They just wanted a chance to see Sarah Palin, and if they were lucky, maybe get a picture. Here in the town of Pella, Iowa, Sarah Palin was greeted by hundreds of devoted fans, all wishing for one thing.
I hope she runs.
I hope she makes her announcement here in Pella.
And while Bristol Palin told Fox News her mother had made her decision, Palin quickly shot that idea down.
Still thinking about it.
Together with her husband Todd to see the premiere of The Undefeated, a movie about her life and leadership, Palin's appearance in this key state has set off a round of speculation about her plans. But Palin, on her way to a barbecue with local residents after the movie, indicated there wouldn't be an announcement from her anytime soon.
There are still many, many months down the road that need to be traveled on before anybody has to make up their mind and declare candidacy.
She didn't exactly discourage the speculation either, telling reporters she appreciated efforts of volunteers and that she would give 110% in Iowa if she decides to run. Craig Robinson, editor of the website iowarepublican.com, says that's what voters in this state have come to expect.
So she'd have to put in a lot of hard work. I think the initial buzz would probably rocket her to the top of the polls, but if she would want to stay there, I think she'd have to put in a lot of shoe leather.
But among the crowd outside the movie theater, the vote was close to unanimous.
I am really all in for Sarah Palin.
She doesn't think of herself as being better than myself or any other person in our community.
And even the few undecided said the movie convinced them she should run.
I definitely have an interest now more in Sarah Palin, and we'll see where it goes from here.
Barbara Kniff McCullough summed it up in two words.
Go Sarah, right?
That's right, yeah.
Now, about 350 people inside watched the movie with Palin. They clapped and cheered throughout the whole movie, especially, Chris, during a part they show a clip of a speech, and she says, "Mr. President, game on." I think they think, you know, that means she may be running. Afterwards, she talked to a lot of people. She said in the movie theater that this movie was not about her, though. It was about American values. Chris?
All right, Jan, tremendous enthusiasm for Sarah Palin last night, as you mentioned, but according to the latest CBS News New York Times poll, the same cannot be said for the rest of the Republican candidates. 67% of those polled not enthusiastic about the current candidate. So what does this say?
That's right, Chris. And those numbers kind of showing that lack of enthusiasm for what some people say is a really lackluster field of Republican candidates so far is why you're seeing a lot of people calling for someone else like Sarah Palin. Now, she's got her own group of loyal fans who are going to be with her no matter what. But you're also seeing this call for someone like a Texas Governor Rick Perry to get in. At the same time, though, there is growing enthusiasm for someone else. And I heard it last night, too. Michelle Bachmann.
There you go. All right. CBS's Jan Crawford in Pella, Iowa. Jan, thanks so much. Talk to you soon.